Assalamu alaikum. Hello, dear students. Today we are going to start with a new chapter in Unit 1, Electricity. Our new chapter is a Chapter 5 about the generators and receivers. But before we introduce these two ideas, we are going to make a revision for the ideas you have learned about in the previous years. The ideas are about potential difference, electric current, and ohmic conductors or resistors. In the learning objectives, you are going to define the potential difference and measure its value, define the electric current, measure and calculate its value, apply the laws of voltage and current in series and in parallel circuits, define the resistance of a resistor, which is an ohmic conductor, and measure its value, plot the IU characteristic curve of a resistor, apply Ohm's law of a resistor, determine the equivalent resistance of resistors connected in series and in parallel. What is the potential difference or the voltage as you have studied in the previous years? To understand the notion of potential difference, let's watch the following video. The teacher in this video is trying to explain the notion of potential difference. We have two tanks, one filled with water and the other is empty. The full one exerts a force, a pressure. In electric language, we say that it has a high potential, unlike the other tank. Then between these two tanks, it is said that there is a potential difference. If now we place a pipe between the two tanks and we open the tap of the pipe, will the water flow between the two tanks? Let us observe. The water flows from the full tank to the empty one. In electric charges, it is exactly the same. If we place a connecting wire between two bodies of different potentials, the electrons flow from the body of the higher potential to the body of the lower potential. And that's what we call the electric current. The electrons are only moving because of voltage or potential difference. When there is no difference in potential, the electrons remain at rest, like the water here in the two tanks after they became at the same potential. Then there is no more flow of electric current. The wires are conductors, so there are free electrons. The dry cell is charged. Electrons are gathered at the negative pole. Here, the electrons are under a force. Here they are relaxed. So we have a potential difference. It is the generator, here the battery, which imposes the voltage. The circulation becomes possible. To recover for the imbalance of charges, the potential difference, the electrons will move. Then, from the video, the potential difference UAB is defined as the difference in the electrical state between two points A and B, characterized by their electric potentials VA and VB respectively. We can write UAB is equal to VA minus VB, or UBA is equal to VB minus VA. Then UAB is equal to negative UBA. The potential difference UAB is an algebraic value. It can be positive, negative, or zero, and it is expressed in volts in the SI unit. Let us consider the following examples. In the first figure, the two particles A and B are of the same electric state, then they have the same electric potentials. Then the potential difference UAB, which is equal to VA minus VB, is equal to 0 volt. Whereas in the second figure, the two particles A and B are of different electric states, then they have different electric potentials. Then the potential difference UAB, which is equal to VA minus VB, is different from 0 volt. What is the electric current? Now, to understand the concept of this physical quantity, let's watch the next video. In this animation, we have in this circuit a generator, a lamp, an electrolytic cell, connecting wires, and a switch. If we magnify a cross-section of the wire, we will find the atoms of copper, and electrons, represented by the blue dots, are moving in random motion. Now, if we close the switch, you will notice that the electrons are drifted in an ordered motion due to the existence of potential difference. Then the electric current is the ordered displacement of the electrons within the metal. The electric current is then defined as the ordered movement or displacement of the electrons within the metal. This movement is caused by the potential difference between two points in the electric circuit. In this circuit, in the absence of potential difference, the electrons are moving randomly, whereas when we have an existence of a potential difference, the electrons moves in an ordered displacement and thus we have a flow of electric current. The direction of electric current. By convention, the direction of electric current is opposite to the direction of electrons. That is, current circulates from the positive terminal to the negative terminal. In the following figure, the current circulates from the positive terminal to the negative terminal, represented by the pink arrow, whereas the particles which represent the electrons moves in the opposite direction from the negative terminal to the positive terminal of the dry cell. The current always circulates or flows from the pole of higher potential to the pole of lower potential. If UAB is positive and UAB is equal to VA minus VB, then VA is greater than VB and the current moves from point A of higher potential to point B of lower potential. The intensity of electric current is the quantity of charges crossing a section of a conductor per unit of time. It is given by the following formula. I is equal to Q divided by T is equal to N times E divided by T. The current I is expressed in ampere A in the SI unit, where Q is the quantity of electric charges in Coulomb crossing the section during T, T is the duration in second, N is the number of electrons crossing the section during T, and E is the elementary charge of value 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 Coulomb. Let us now talk about the instruments of measurement for the potential difference and the electric current. For the voltage, the most commonly used device is a multimeter functioning as a voltmeter. This device should be connected in parallel with the load you are measuring its voltage. For the current, we use a multimeter functioning as an ammeter, and the multimeter functioning as an ammeter should be connected in series across the device you are measuring the intensity of current traversing it. Let us also talk about the laws of electrical voltage and current. In series grouping, we apply the law of addition of voltage, that is, UPN is equal to UPA plus UAB plus UBC plus UCD plus UDN. Also, we apply the law of uniqueness of current, that is, the main current is equal to I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3, which are the current traversing the first load, the second load, and the third load, respectively. In parallel grouping, we apply the law of uniqueness of voltage, which is the voltage across L1 is equal to the voltage across L2 is equal to the voltage across the motor is equal to the voltage across the generator. Whereas we apply the law of addition of current, that is, the main current is divided into I1 plus I2 plus I3. For electric current, in general, at any junction or node in the electric circuit, we can apply the junction rule, which indicates that the sum of all the current entering to the junction is equal to the sum of all current leaving this junction. In this figure, I1 and I3 are entering the junction, and I2 and I4 are leaving the junction, then we can write I1 plus I3 is equal to I2 plus I4.
Till now, we have finished reviewing the first part related to the basic ideas of potential difference and electric current. I leave you now to confirm your information by solving the questions that we have chosen for you in your agenda. Thank you for watching.